Love, one.
Well, last match of the evening session beginning here. Once again, the quarterfinals. That's the prize on offer, a spot within them. Some in the women's draw and a classy start from the youngest member of the world's top 10 right now, Xin Yubin, up one against four. The wild card. 30 were in on ranking. Seems a while ago now with everything that's gone on, but in terms of the starts of the draws, 30 in on ranking and a couple of wildcard spots. One of those in the women's draw awarded to Germany's Sabina Winter. She's certainly justified it. Ready with a victory and competing here tonight. First long from Shen, but Winter equal to it.
Yeah, different stylistic matchup here for Winter. Obviously, she overcame Linda Bergström, a defender from Sweden, in the last round, who got to the final of contender this season. Oh, but there's the slingy forehand that she has. Quite unique the way that she plays it, but the fundamentals are there. Early timing point, she transfers her weight from right leg through to left and uses her waist and her back very well in that forehand.
3-2.
That early contrast to kind of identify and follow, isn't there, where you've got Shin in a classic, if you like, modern player style. She doesn't mind a little step back, but actually quite likes generally to be close to the table.
Yeah.
Those hops around on her toes. And then you've got Winter, who's actually doesn't mind being away from the table and employing that forehand you mentioned.
Yeah, she's got a very free style, Winter. Chases the forehand, isn't afraid to go back and lob. Two beautiful switches down that line so far from Xin Yubin. Freezing Winter.
4-3.
There and a great read off the long fast kicker. Awesome forehand from Sabine Winter.
4-5.
She's always been a player. Talk about playing in terms of the atmosphere. Best victories in a career have often been in that sort of setting where she thrives on it. Engages with the crowd, as you suggested already, her table tennis allows her to engage with the crowd as well as Tamara Borosz. So, the coach of the German women's team.
And with how well she moves, you forget how long she's represented Germany. You know, more than 10 years, more than a decade. Xin Yubin shovel serves. Can really help dig her out of trouble. Very fine line between topspin and backspin. It's all about where she contacts it and how she comes into it. If it's from above, probably backspin.
5-8.
Dangerous, dangerous game. Trying to go fire with Shin. Oh. Right into that middle.
Yeah.
Just 9-5.
There. Too much on it. A bit too deep. Shin here rolling away at the moment with this first game.
Nice guided flick there. right into the backhand of Shin, but obviously surprised her enough to make the error.
Not quite. Same thing again. Looks like it's slipping away from Winter. Had a chance there. Misses out. So 11, there's the opening game for Shin Yubin.
1-love.
Shin Yubin, a game to the good. Mentioned the WTT finals, of course, for the women in Nagoya. Into the 17th of December, and Shin is already there thanks to the season that she's had, already qualified. We'll be taking part there in Japan, 15th to 17th of December.
Dub two.
She's the youngest player in the world's top 10. Doing so well on the contender scene, and she's barely had any losses against lower ranked players. That's how she's maintained that for some time now.
1-2.
If she wins this, she'll have the match that she really wants to have against Sun Ying Sha.
Please play.
What a slap there from Shin Yubin. That really is a kick in the shin.
Yeah, 12 of the last 16 points here.
Oh, as is that.
1-6.
And all cards on the table, forehand from Winter, but an ace block. An obvious tactic is just to attack, attack, attack. You've got to be mindful of what you actually give, in a sense. Because then if your opponent can block it, you barely got any time to recover.
Seven,
so many
two.
Things to be conscious of.
She's seeing the funny side of it. She's almost back there with the best seats in the house. Side of the arena there. She's sent all everywhere by that quality of ball strike. Yeah, go and take a seat. This is impressive.
Nine.
Shin Yubin here. It's a player. She's in good form here at home, and just how she's controlling the match here.
10-2.
I mentioned qualifying for Nagoya for the WTT final, singles, doubles, and everything really. I mean, she's tremendous. Winter smiling again, accepting that she's been second best in the second game. Shin has taken this to another level. 8 game points. And needs just
11,
the one.
Two.
I mean, that's up there as
game
one of the best
two,
individual
Shin.
Games.
One love. 1-0.
She's been to a quarter-final before already in her young career, Shen Yubin. Xin Xian. It's her third WTT Champions tier event. Has been to that and trying to match that here. She can carry on what she's been doing.
2-1.
Well, that was where she picked up one of the best wins in her career, beating Han Ying. European number one and best chopper in the world, Winter's teammate. She's got a 72% win rate against Europeans, and I expect that to go up, actually.
Let 2-1.
She's only played a European 61 times. Only played around 100 matches in her career. Many more, hopefully, to come.
Just elaborate a little bit more. She fires another one away there. Is it just in terms of the fundamentals, what she does, that it's just a very... It's a fantastic game style, but a very difficult game style for European players to, I guess, to come up against.
Well, there's no obvious weakness, really, with Shen Yubin. Barely gives you any time. Flicks well.
1-3.
Good touch play. A suffocating serve. Hard attacks. That's amazing.
1-4.
What more can Vin to do? That's why she's smiling there.
Mm. You're absolutely right. She played a great point there. And there's nothing doing at the end of it. Vinta this time. It's just to keep reproducing that, having the opportunity to do that is the problem. She can accelerate like that, but it's doing it consistently.
Four.
Nice switch there though from Vinta. Guide flick to middle. There again with spin, and look at that. Playing some nice shots, meeting the ball well. But like you say, Guy, it's a case of how often. Oh, and that is audacious.
4-5. Left 6-5.
trying to switch there. Trying to still stay aggressive, but it's just so difficult. Not much to work with a lot of the time. Quality of this ball that's coming at her.
I think despite the speed of Vinter, the thing that really stands out for me is balance. And Shin Yibin has that really, really well with the wide base. As she has, and balances herself with a free arm. Very high free arm.
Seven all.
That little short, really deft touch, push receive there, Shin. So good. I mean,
eight,
how she
seven.
Kind of resets their midpoint, because as she said, her balance allows her to, her footwork, her base. Even there where Winter is giving as good as she's getting, and she needs to reset and fade slightly across that, she's able to do it because of her base.
And doesn't go too hard too soon. Constructs it and even finishes it with some finesse. Gorgeous, Shin Yibin.
To making a good piece of it here in game three, though. And a good receive in on that shovel in the middle.
That man there, Coach Cho Onrei, former national team member of Korea Republic.
8-9.
Go to a third towel break. No, I think the thing is with Shin Yibin, it's a wonderful base. You wonder, she does come through here, the ultimate test awaiting next is just in terms of that footwork and how dynamic consistently it can be, especially when it's put heavily under pressure. In terms of trying to avoid hesitancy in the footwork and the movements. And so we're able to find a way there. Shin with the service two away. Well done!
9-10.
Attacking firebrand play from Vinter.
Pedal to the medal there. Not failing, had Shin Yibin flailing.
Game point here for the German. Take it into a fourth. The old faithful.
10-all.
Tried the beaver block there. Bit of topspin on it and she came up it. But it's such a suffocating serve.
Vinter forehand is delivering. Drive there through Shin's defences.
Through a few, it was like 3.4 runs. But the final one with the side spin. Brilliant movement.
Second game point. Oh, in the back edge as well.
Love.
Decent placement that to the middle. doing the work again for Winter.
Playing the parallels very nicely. There, and then there. The H is on the table. And again.
One.
Spinning and winning, forever grinning, Sabina Winter.
Shin here, just getting on with it. Just looking to ride out the storm.
Two, three.
Is that the right tactic, if it indeed? I mean, just judging by what she's doing here. Not any massive changes.
Winter can get those extra balls back, and sometimes Shin Yibin does tense in the longer rallies. She can stay consistent, she's really got a chance.
Yeah, you mentioned in the previous game, Fraser, about the wide base, and it's quite iconic already with Shin Yibin sitting around like that. But actually, see where you come from a bit, that you can, if you can extend it like that, there is a bit of hesitancy sometimes in the footwork.
Her footwork when she plays the shot, her transfer of weight is very good, but it's what she does in between shots. With that wide base, how active can you be, for example, in taking the initiative and stepping round to impose yourself more?
Four, three.
Because that's what really separates Sin Ying Sha from the rest of the pack. She will step, if she gets caught out occasionally, fine. Because she steps straight away, basically, for that forehand.
Almost got there, you know.
She is rapid, but if you step and play the forehand like Winter was there, even though she lost the rally, she's not going to lose the rally most times. You can penetrate more with a forehand. If you stay close, you're kind of wanting to feed off that pace. You can generate a lot of speed with a short stroke with a backhand, don't get me wrong. If you want to play a bullet, probably going to be with a forehand.
Five, four.
That was better there from Shin Yibin with that set piece. But if it went against the set piece, say she went down the line there, Winter, I think Shin would have got caught out. So maybe sometimes she's moving a little bit too early. Either that or being too reactive and not moving early enough.
Four, six.
Yeah, control of the exchange early on to punch it away. So impressive, this. This is how she was playing, into the elbow.
And time out.
And there again, she's on the comeback.
Forehand is so good. Second guess there. Shin got in the spin, but look at that.
Seven, five.
Such a fast service motion that Sabina Winter has. It's quite sporadic, quite jagged. Quite off-putting in a way, but Shin dealing with it quite nicely. She's controlling well this game, Shin. She's getting the occasional ball hit past her, but she's blocked wonderfully. She has to do because she stays close. That's one thing you have to do well if you do that. Block well.
Eight, five.
And also read where the power shot is coming as well. It's one thing that a lobber has more of. Time. But of course then the opponent does as well.
Nine.
That's why staying close is considered an advantage.
It definitely is in the women's game.
Yeah.
Four,
out there.
I mean,
so many great players close to the table. The last decade in particular, and those who are active at the moment, she's been very much in that modern style. 2 points away.
10-6.
Now, looking to repel this effort from Vinsa and finish her off. Four match points here for Shin. There we go then.
11-6.
It's another WTT Champions level quarterfinal to look forward to.